Recording. Okay, so I'm starting new game here. I just finished the campaign and I must say it's awesome. That's why I haven't been posting anything lately or transmitting. The game is pretty tough. There's a lot of things to gather and explore, a lot of places. I didn't manage to figure out all of the clues or the side quests, which is sad actually. But I do know that whatever I do, I want to do the lone wolf thing, because managing inventory for other people is simply painful. I don't know which players I should pick. I had beast on my side. I was a female lizard on the previous quest. I had beast, I had red prince, and I had one more person. Oh yeah, Fane, the guy. Yeah, so that's it. Genius. Okay, encourage. Now those are pretty tough. Okay, let's see. Appearance. This is Sable, so not Sable, Lossy. So I will keep their appearance as it is by default. Although the appearance is switched to... Okay, so it is Battle March Cleric. That's what I'm getting for, going for actually. One-handed fighter, oh yeah, this is it. I want a sword or something, shields as a secondary thing, or no, shields. We will see how that goes. Preset edit, I don't want any constitution because, oh yeah, and talents I want. Opportunities maybe not now. I want lone wolf. And I will pick up Pet Pal as the next one. And she will not look like that way anyway. Inquisitor, Knight, what's this? Never use this. Metamorph. Cool, Ranger, I always liked Rangers, I like rogues. The base seems fine. Talents, we already got one. Presets, no penis. We will take strength. Strength all day. Confirm. And attributes, no scoundrel, no to polymorph. No to serum fevery. I want. I got this one. Okay, I want bartering. Persuasion, I mean. Because it's quite important for the story. Okay, so next up. Uh, I forgot to save it. Okay. Okay, so next up, this thing, I want summoning, because I want to pick Phoenix here. I will change this. Let's leave the cello. Commons we got. Yeah, this one. Not gorilla, I want lone wolf. So now presets. Yeah. This looks good. Talent, summoning, persuasion. Sneaking at least one attribute point to this, and I will want the ability to teleport if sticking, but that will come later, I guess. So let's go summoning two. My summoning champion will have 2 points, so 50% more vitality. Yeah, sounds really good. So skills. I have this one. Let's try actually. If I remove summoning and pick necromancy, for instance, from necromancy I will get nothing that I need or like. From polymorph. For some reason, polymorph I get only one. I could get cloak, which is quite cool. Like chicken claw is also really good. But no. Geomancer is also quite useful because it has this thing, which slows down everyone, and fortify provides armor. Yeah, those will be good. So Geomancer, Forge, I like this one, the Bold, and I like Favorable Winds, although with fewer people this will be less important. This was also quite useful in the game that I played. Hydro Sophist. Okay, Rain is really useful, we can take out fire. This is really important. No, it's not the one. Restoration is quite good. So yeah, I think Hydro something will be most important. Pyrokinetics. And this is so-so. Peace of mind is pretty good. It removes quite a few things. Ignition, set an enemy char, turn around and with fire, haste, sets haste on target. Yeah, I like this one, but Hydro seems the best. Scoundrel. Confirm, edit. Box up is really good, adrenaline is really good to finish up guys when you have the option. Chloroform was pretty useful, but I'm not going for that kind of build. Huntsman will probably be useless. I plan to use, this is really good, it heals a lot of things. I won't be needing those things, so no thank you. And Warfare has also pretty good things. Warfare has this and this. That's why I will take it. So this allows me to move fast to the enemy, and this will allow me to throw my shield at people, and it will bounce once to the other guys. This is also pretty good. This was really useful, especially in the beginning of the game. So I will have conjured creature and those two attacks, which I quite like. Okay, summoning plus warfare, persuasion, strength, yeah, that works for me. Talents are okay. Let's listen to the story.
All my life I've been a performer, a musician, beloved and celebrated by all. But I have a secret. I'm also a playground for sprites and spirits and... worse. The voice that rings inside me now is darker than any that came before. Almost caused a bunch of my fans to rip each other to pieces. But you can trust me. I've got this under control. Step one, find out who or what is trying to take control of my mind. Step two, make it sorry it ever tried.
Okay, pretty cool. I remember her. I killed her in the last game. That's also something that I want to try, not killing everyone else. Not sure about how my quest will go. I will miss sneaking. Yes, I'm sure I'm done with the charge card.
It all happened like I knew it would. A single drop of sauce magic. And like flies to honey, the monsters swarmed. The rabble panicked. The carnage began. And the magisters pointed their fingers at me. Just as I'd planned. I was shackled and collared and sent to Fort Joy. I'd come here to kill Godwoken. But instead, I became part of their story.
Still a bit groggy, are we? Don't worry. The sedative will wear off soon enough. Easy now. No need to hurry. Get your bearings and report to me upstairs.
Here I was, hoping my upstairs visitor was just playing tricks on me.
Okay, here we go.
Who are you? Nobody.
So, as per standard procedure in those kind of games, let's go exploring. This thing is locked. I cannot talk to animals. Which is too bad.
Hey, a
a sheep.
Shaking her fluffy coat, the sheep eyes you balefully, her rectangular eyes like letterboxes to the void. With one sharp hoof, she kicks you right in the shin.
But no damage.
Did you expect a needle?
I can point with a long branch. Card the door key. No knives. I'm disappointed. What's the return dates? Okay, so we know what this is about. Dipped is there and need to pick this up. And put it on this one. Quick. So I did 3 to 4 and with this I do 4 to 5. But I can still punch someone. So that's how it works. This ability needs to be farther down. Cannot move it. Oh, it's locked. Sorry. If I enabled it, then it's fine. Just something that will be there all the time. It's one of the mods that I installed, the sprinting thing. Because, quite frankly, those guys move slow. This is a key, old rusty key, crocodile. It weighs something. And I will have a lot of keys by the end of the game. Yeah, I final the tutorial level. Read it. As a virtuous part of Civiliet, we need to look into further into the past. But the Swords King's trying to understand the havoc such as magics may wreak. All the other order must follow. Okay.
Rubbish.
I was surprised at the beginning of the game that this cannot be used as a shield. Why wouldn't it be? Let's steer. Not sure what to get of this empty stuff. Mashed apples? No.
empty.
Why does it tell me empty when I go to everything? If it's empty. It's empty, it's empty. Gold cup.
Why, you're look, there you are. Not too tight, I hope. The collar, I mean. In the meantime, your next stop will be Magister William. All passengers have to be registered in the ship's manifest, and he's the chap in charge of the logs. You'll find him on the other side of this deck, in the officers' quarters. Don't you dare! If you violate the virtue of my carpet, I'll do a good thing worse than put a collar around your neck.
Index fingers pressed to her lips. She pauses a moment to give you a scrutinizing gander.
My word, you do seem a bit befuddled, don't you? Perhaps I was a bit too generous with that sedative. Oh, well, I'm sure you'll soon gather your wits. Most likely. Eventually. In the meantime, all you need to know is that we're en route to Fort Joy. A new life awaits, and if you're a particularly good girl, perhaps a cure as well. An end to Source for good.
Why we are colored?
Why, for my peace of mind, of course. Why don't you try casting one of those Source spells of yours? See what happens.
Currents of magic surge inside you, boiling, bursting, then breaking, only to fade back into your soul like rain into the earth.
My, look at the concentration on your face. All will, but no result. There you have it. See? The collar's function. It neuters you of sorts, makes you unable to cast Source. For your own peace of mind, of course. Yours. And the whole world's.
Good gods! There's been a murder here.
A young magister stands pale and silent. Her knuckles whiten around her weapon as you pass. Behind the magister, a bloodied mass lies in a heap. Gore and limbs lie at odd angles. You can't make out a face amid the mess.
Easy now. You're pale in the arse. Why don't you move along? Waters is investigating. She'll figure out who did it. Always does. Hands to yourself, bloody sorcerer.
Ugly sight, isn't it? Burns me up this happened under our protection. We're extremely lucky no Voidwalk and followed the Source that did this. Finn didn't see it like that. He was desperate for us to help him. Two things scared the living daylights out of him. His own shadow and his own Source. We'll find out who did this. Speaking of...
She looks up at you with a mirthless smile.
I was on duty in your room when the murder happened. You were asleep the whole time. Didn't even stir. You're one of the only indisputably innocent people on the ship. Unless you can commit murder in your sleep, of course. I thought as much. Listen, I could use someone to keep their ears open among the passengers. Sometimes they clam up in front of a uniform. Bring me a good lead. I'll throw in a shiny gold coin for you. How about that?
Sure.
Thanks. I just want to catch whoever did this before they hurt anyone else.
Murdering people is bad. Nice. Right, up to hers. I will be able to sell all the arrows. I am wondering what my colleague should be like. I have summoning. I will be fighting close quarters. So I need someone longer range probably. Okay, so she was the one playing with the kids.
I know who you are. You're a singer. My mum likes you.
Cool.
I know you. I heard you sing once. Before. Out there. Wow.
Can I sing? Guess not. Gets with colors.
I don't like comedy. Well, you aren't here on my list. Scrammy, we're trying to catch a killer here.
The elf is reading a volume of Cranley Hubert's famous encyclopedia. He looks up, his big round eyes scanning your body, absorbing every detail. He reaches out and takes your hand, turning it this way and that, examining it from every angle. Finally, he pinches your skin, gently tugging at it.
Fascinating.
He sits back and returns to his book, flicking quickly from page to page, completely oblivious to your presence.
I have already examined it and found it quite ordinary. What more could I possibly... Oh dear, I seem to have crossed some cultural taboo. How difficult. You have my apologies, human. Perhaps I should demand the same from those red-cloaked humans. They laid their hands on me more than once. Perhaps. Perhaps not. Understanding is all rather relative. Take this book, for example. I understand all of it, and yet none of it makes sense. It is simultaneously too detailed and insufficient. I know the beginning of this tale and the end, but I am rather missing the middle. Tell me, what do you know of our world's history? Most unusual, and if it's not too rude to suggest, not much of an answer. No, I want to know about the celestial. I want to know about your gods. This text tells me that they created all creatures, but nothing of what came before. Where did these gods come from? Who are their people? Where are the others of their kind? Of course you don't have any useful information. Why did I expect anything else? Now please, run along. I have a world to decipher.
No amount of pestering will get the elf to take his eyes off his book or respond to your question.
I'm sure this discussion will come this way.
Good. Magister Williams has just about done with the last passenger. You faring okay so far?
He tugs the collar of his uniform and chuckles.
Sorry you're upset, ma'am, but we all wear what we wear for a reason. If you head on in now, Williams will get you sorted fast.
Okay, later.
One of us will get our own. They're picking us off one by one.
Can we just skip to the part where I reassure you and you shut up?
You think me mad?
Mad?
You one of them. A divine order loyal. Thank you.
A brawny dwarf sits totally upright on the bench, eyes closed. He raises an eyebrow as you approach, but doesn't open his eyes.
Beast.
Listen up, Geralt. You hear that?
He turns his head toward you, looking you up and down. And smiles before turning his attention to the ship once more.
You look like a girl to me. Listen if you're interested, or get gone if you aren't.
His eyes snap open. He looks at you and frowns.
Murder? Ah, that's what they were going on and on about. I wouldn't know anything about it. I kill a man. He knows who done it. His daddy knows who done it. And the mayor knows who done it.
His eyes flutter shut, and he assumes his position of repose once more.
Whether they catch me is another matter, but I ain't one to hide my accomplishments. The ship, of course.
A wave of sound.
And? Sick as a leper's cat. From the state of it, I'd say she's being cared for by a bunch of beardless babes who never loved anyone but their own mums. But there's more. Listen close.
Close your eyes and listen.
There now, just like that. Squee! Ha
ha! His eyes snap open as his countenance breaks into an expression of joy. One great paw claps you on the back, the other catches you before you lose your footing.
There, you heard it, didn't you? I knew it, I knew it. Aye, this is good news, kiddo. Good news.
That was nothing more than a rat. Not you hear it. What's it supposed to be?
It's the wheel, don't you see, you beautiful idiot? Squeaks whenever the helmsman jerks it clockwise, which means we're heading east.
Interesting.
Lord my beard. That means if we've been traveling for, yes, only 10.34 nautical miles to Fort Joy. Yeah, no indeed, Gil. But that ain't my final destination.
The dwarf leans back from the table and strokes his beard, gold medallions jingling merrily. His eyes roll over to you.
That'll be all. Thank you kindly, Gil.
He continues stroking his beard, a beatific smile on his lips, and doesn't acknowledge you anymore.
Okay.
Never thought you'd end up.
I spent my life singing for my slaves to bring me my supper. Finer fare than boiled roots and rotten tubers, too. Meanwhile, the magisters feast on honeyed meat behind this very wall. The indignity.
As soon as the Inquisitor gets here, we'll hang you right over the side of this ship with him.
Well, well, what have we here? A fresh face in this stale hell. Let's size you up, shall we? See if you'll do.
The lizard looks you up and down, like a farmer would a fetching horse. All of a sudden, he grips you firmly by the chin, with the intent of inspecting your teeth.
There's some discoloration, but I've seen worse. After all, one can't expect to find prime merchandise on a squalid little ship like this. Now then, to business. You will answer me three questions. The first one is this. Can you cook? Oh, goodness, no. Don't even mention the demon's testes that are turnips. On to the second question. Can you knit, weave? In short, tailor?
Nope.
Yes, I can tell from your vagabond chic, a bag is as good as a shirt kind of style. I shouldn't be getting my hopes up. On then to my final query. Have you the ability to administer the upkeep of one's personal appearance? The delicate art of cosmetics is what I'm after. Dear Lord, I might as well try and teach mathematics to a dog chasing its tail. So, three questions asked, three questions answered. Let's evaluate. As per your own testimony, you have the taste buds of a dung beetle, the fashion sense of a monkey in a clown suit, and your personal hygiene reminds one of a carcass rotting in the sun. That won't do at all, see? I'm sad to say I must deny you the opportunity to be my slave. Ever so sorry. I know, but you just don't have what it takes. A good slave's made of sterner stuff, I'm afraid.
Too bad.
Hone your skills, and one day you may just qualify for a position in a lesser household than mine. You keep dreaming, you hear?
Till overboiling a bit of cabbage becomes a crime, I shall hold my head steady.
They even can take a water bottle. Too simple, and it means that I have to move everything around, which is not good. Afterwards, inventory is the same. How about can do it?
I'm busy watching for clues, sorcerer. Good. A scruffy man lounges against the wall with scarred arms folded.
Watch your back, new fish. There's a murderer on board, and I bet 3 months' pay is this tramp Ifan.
Rolling his eyes at the Magister's warning, the man named Ifan beckons again. He leans in and adjusts your collar with a sharp tug, balancing its weight so it no longer presses unpleasantly on your neck. He winks.
Pinches less that way, right?
Hocking a phlegmy gobbet in your general direction, the sullen magister settles back to his task of glowering at Ifan. And now, you.
We used to know each other, more's the pity. I was his commander many, many, many moons ago. Isn't that right, Vic?
Standing far back from Ifan, the tight-faced magister draws one finger across his throat in an elaborate fashion, but says nothing. Ifan grins, flashing pointed white teeth.
Same as he was at 14 years old. Only difference is somebody gave him a bigger sword, and now he's Johnny Big Pants. Long story. Maybe I'll tell you about it in the joy. Away from interested parties. No. The dead man, Finn, is it? I'd no business with him. And I wouldn't put a man down without good reason.
He glances over at Magister Victor, who's staring back at him with pointed intensity.
Damn shame sheer annoyance isn't reason enough. The joy. I've heard a lot.
Joy.
Nothing good. No surprise there, since Bishop Alexander runs the show. Wonder if we'll get to meet the Ringmaster himself. Not interested in the son of the divine himself. I don't blame you one bit. But Vic here will blow a blood vessel if he hears you talking like that.
What are you conspiring about over there? You! What's your name?
Oh, don't mind him. Vic's just got a bee in his bonnet. And that bee is me.
Name?
Magister Victor looks at you suspiciously, then scrawls something illegible down in a tiny notebook. He scowls at you as he stows the notebook back in his voluminous robes.
Away with you, at once.
Ifan performs an elaborate pantomime of keeping quiet, one finger in front of his lips as he leans back against the wall.
Okay. So, Sibyl
sits tucked away in a dark spot, lazily rolling dice onto the surface of a barrel.
But snake eyes.
She chuckles.
I bet that's just what they'll look like. Rolling dice, deciding fates. Don't worry, honey. It isn't yours.
She looks you up and down with the merest hint of a coy smile on her lips.
Never say never, though.
She eyes you quite seriously.
Not the future, no. But I can read the past in flesh. One of the perks of being an elf, you see. I'm quite good at it, too. I could lick your arm and tell you how you spent the night before last. Shall I?
She gives your arm a vigorous stroke of the tongue, efficient, like a cat groomed.
You were in a cellar with other sorcerers. A dark, dank place. I remember it well. As everyone lay sleeping, you sat in the dark with wakeful eyes, looking rather lovingly at... me! My, aren't you a pretty cup full of sugar and spice? Of course it is. But don't you worry, darling. Your secret's safe with me. I don't lick and tell.
Okay. So there's one more key to find. But I don't have enough strength to move this crate. If I had telepathy, I would be able to move it. This is empty. Let's take another bedroll. We will sell all of those.
Oh, the hatch is blocked. I'll need to find another way.
How about this way? We can find room. It's empty. So this is the only way up, and there's a mess over there. So moving down here, what can we find? Not much, actually. Steer. How can we?
Junk.
How can we get in here? We can destroy those doors. But there should be an easier way in there. There should be key somewhere. Simple as that. And I can still do the fight over there. Chicken coop. There's only 60. So I can carry one or the other. I can find lockpicks. Yeah. But I don't really have the...
Hey! Get me out of this cage and I'll make it worth your while. You in? Your guess is as good as mine. Someone screamed loud as a banshee. After that,
pure pandemonium. They never even told me what I was accused of. Just dragged me down here. Set me free, and I'll set you free. A fair trade, I should think.
The Magister Guard snorts and sniffles as he sleeps. You're all...
Is my shift over? You here to relieve me?
Wait, you're no Magister. You're a sorcerer. What are you doing here, filthy scrounger? Choose your words carefully. My fists ache to meet a new face.
About time too. The lads and lasses up there are getting lazy. Figures they'd send one of you sorcerers down. They can barely be chuffed to wiggle a single toe. Can't just leave the prisoner alone though. I heard he might be the one causing trouble upstairs. That's all I needed to hear. Just don't let that caged rascal fool you. You can't trust him as far as you can throw him.
Ignore me, but you should know a gentlewoman among jesters you are. Give that lever a pull, and I guarantee we'll both get something out of the deal.
The prisoner's buoyant voice darkens as his eyes rest on yours.
Ah, freedom. Tastes better than wine. I'm nothing if not a man of my word. And I did give my word I'd set you free, lass. Say your prayers while you've breath to speak them. The halls await.
Really? Does he have... fire resistant of any kind? No. So why the hell would he... How much can I do? What should I still? Cool. No one has opportunities? He has opportunities. Cool. Bedrolls, nothing else here. He has a bit of gold, it's fine. I prefer a weapon or two, but what can you do? Not really anything else I can see here. Oh, I think I could find this. Can move this, I can move this. No key. I have lots of bucket though. Bedroll will go here. I don't need this barrel here, I don't need this, I will not be using this. I don't need this here. Where else could it be? I don't think I left it here. Oh, I moved something. I should destroy those doors, unfortunately. Really, no other way. 5, 4. Oh, I can ask him for that. This does 2 damage and he does 6 damage. That's actually better. Okay, this will take a moment. Attack. I can still enter sneak mode, even though I have 0 sneaking. 5 and destruct. See what we have here. We have cards, which we will sell. We have this lever, which does absolutely nothing. I did do something, because it was a large bunk, a loud bunk. Equip this one.
No key? No problem.
No problem, still.
Empty.
Empty. How awful. I'm disappointed about this room. I could really use something better. Okay. What this loud bang was about. Did it actually do something anyway? Is there anything? I want this here, and I don't want this at all. Or actually, I don't have any specific abilities that will work with only one hand. So having two hands do something is good. So nothing. Cool. Let's go. Nothing more here.
I ain't seen.
Okay, then let's go.
Standing at the center of the room, you spot a sorcerer haughtily eyeing a pair of nervous-looking magisters. They keep their crossbow trained upon her as she's being interrogated by an officer.
So you admit it then? You murdered that poor fella?
Yes, I did. But of course, that was only the beginning.
She turns her head and looks you straight in the eye.
There are others whose lives must end.
Good God! The woman's mad! You there, sorcerer! Go and fetch Magister Siwan! We need to do more than collar this maniac. We need to shackle her hands and feet.
It means your journey draws to a close. Do stick around for its finale, though, because...
She reaches for her collar and simply removes it.
I'm just about to create a scene.
Subdue her, man, quickly! If she casts off, the void welcome.
She smiles with wicked satisfaction.
Precisely.
Kaboom.
What's happened?
You've got a shield. Oops. Nope, we must steal ink. I was only stealing a little. Ah, yes, this looks awesome. Though the damage it does, it's pretty insignificant. Compared to what you already have. More empty cups. At the beginning of the game, everything you can sell is a good thing. It's this thing here. I guess nothing. Oh. Notes. none of them drop their weapons. A few of them are in good spirits with the children. The other are solid. Don't blame them. Change is rough. Cute. This is the same. 1-1-3-1-1 in front. 1-1-3-1 in the head. Yep, looks like it. Oh yeah, I want to grab. Oh, now I have. I'm heavy. Not really need this. Keep the stern room. Yeah, that was probably the room. Yeah, everyone is sleeping.
If Ant lies motionless, curled his eyes. Lucy. If Ant cries out, then his eyes fall closed again.
Sibyl.
No, not the final dark. Not yet.
It's no use. Your words do not seem to reach
the dice roll darkly. They're rolling for me.
Not really about it.
The dwarf lies in a heap on the floor, his great beard twisted and tangled around him. He is stopped. You hear a faint thud, thud, thud. He's alive, but only just.
Where's his friends?
The turners.
What? Why, for goodness sake?
The lizard's eyes close as he slips into unconsciousness. Magister lies on the floor, unconscious and bleeding from a dire-looking wound.
Color mask. Which one leads to the next level and which one leads to... That makes things simple. People modded having it all the time on.
Lord, damn it!
strength and quick.
I want this shield. Too bad, there's not one of the things I can get. Why telekinesis is good. So you can lift things. No matter on their weight.
Painted mist. You press your palm against the door to open it. The wood feet.
Feed me too long. Because I have no fever. Boom. So the things I'm missing is 2-handed weapons here. And spear. 2 spears are quite useless. I found the key.
Your belly goes hollow and your skin goes pale. It doesn't budge. The door groans open. But
anything else? Not really. Stairs.
You pass through the door, the skeleton.
Damn fools record knowledge on a pulped tree. It catches fire, it turns into must when wet. It cannot even resist acid. No wonder they're so bloody ignorant.
The skeleton looks up and notices you for the first time.
Oh, it's you. Shouldn't you be running and screaming or some such?
The skeleton groans and looks back to his book, frantically flipping from page to page.
Yes, indeed. It's the look of someone that wants to read the bloody book he's holding. Now, if you're really quite finished, I believe you have lifeboats to flee to. Please, I was no more an elf than you are those rags you're wearing. I had a mask, rather ingeniously designed, which allowed me to take that primitive form. A mask that was stolen by that damned witch after her little scene. Still, she'll drown with the rest of these fools, and I will simply pluck my mask from her cold, dead hands.
The skeleton holds up his book in one quick, frustrated movement.
I am trying to discover if there is anyone worth saving, and I will be damned if I let the lives of some mayflies get in my way. Go on, go, swim or drown or do whatever takes your fancy. I have a book to read.
Mm-hmm. Let's go upstairs. I have magic armor? Where did I get magic armor from? Oh, this one, okay. That's a bit cool. What? Oh, this is encourage. So nice encourage. That went fast. I have boots now. And a fireball, my strength grows. Okay, it would be nice if this would also stop being on fire. But I can leap through it, it's no problem. Okay, so I have armor protecting me. What else is there? Magister. Some stupid one that I don't believe. Okay, I'm not here. Yep. I get slowed. Kill. Trace. Yeah, that's cool. I have a helmet pocket.
Shut your trap, kid. Children and dwarfs first, just like the old stories say.
Yeah.
The dwarf yanks at one of the nearby ropes to no avail.
You said there were other people down there. We need to help them.
You see those tentacles, kid?
Time for getting the hell out of here. Thank you. There's a ladder right over there. You can go straight down.
You're gonna be the death of us, you hear?
I was like to kill those two guys or rescue them, whatever comes first. Let's get blood. Yeah. We can handle those two rights. Are they immune to something? Yep. We are level 1 stuff. He will move and he will get hit. Yeah, but I still would like to go for those two guys. But for that I would need a key, which I don't have. Heavy. Let's leave this.
She tries to speak, but can only gape as she clutches her neck, trying to stem the bleeding of a gushing wound. With jagged movements, she raises her clenched fist and holds out a length of cloth soaked with some kind of strong-smelling tincture. Blood quickly soaks through the cloth. Magister Siyuan's mouth opens and closes, her eyes wide in terror. Blood pours out from around the bandage. Magister Siyuan reaches out to you, her hand flailing. It's working. The pressure is stemming the flow of blood. Siyuan clutches your arm, her eyes locked with yours. Something within the ship snaps. The floorboards shudder. Siyuan struggles to her feet, clinging to you tightly. The ship lets out a deep groan, then cracks.
Honorable Dallas, we lost a ship sailing sorcerer prisoners to Fort Joy. We assume some escaped and broke their collars. Their vile magic lured the Voidwoken. All who were aboard are presumed dead. Yours faithfully into eternity, High Judge Orivan.
Okay, so we try to help her. Point for us. You're nice.
he's right about one thing. First comes Source, then comes Voidwoken. Am I the lone survivor?
Okay, I will end here.
Thanks, disembodied voice.
We'll continue later.